All right, well, as you just saw, Treasurer Josh Frydenberg is refusing to concede defeat to Monique Ryan in the seat of Kooyong, and we spoke to the Teal Independent earlier today. Well, as we saw there, Monique Ryan is hoping to have pulled off another Teal steal from Josh Frydenberg, and she joins us now from the seat of Kooyong. Monique, I want to say congratulations, but Josh Frydenberg says it's not over. Is there a chance that you could still lose this?
Look, I don't think so. At this point, it really looks as though, from our modelling, as though the decision in Kooyong is pretty much finalised. But we haven't heard from Mr Frydenberg as yet, and we are awaiting that telephone call with some enthusiasm.
OK, well, I hope you don't have your phone on silent, because we'd love to witness it if it happens live on air. Monique, Zoe Daniel told us only about a week ago that there was very little interaction or communication between all of the Teals, apart from, I think, a small WhatsApp group where you were all checking in with each other to make sure that you were OK. Is that communication now going to grow between all of you, and do you have a group party planned at this point?
Lisa, yeah, I think I'm sure we will be talking to each other a bit more. For one thing, we'll all be living in the same city for a significant part of the year, so we will see a bit more of each other, and obviously interactions in the workplace. We'll have to have some discussions over the next week or so as the composition of the parliament becomes clear and as to what our role will be. So we will continue to build on those very preliminary discussions, but we won't function as a party. We've all been elected as independents for our own electorates, and that will continue to be the case.
Sorry, I didn't mean a party as in a political party. I meant some champagne, perhaps.
A party party. Yeah, I meant a party as a party party. Yeah, there will be a bottle of champagne at some
Good.
Stage, I'm sure.
Glad to hear it.
Obviously, the criticism of you lot in the lead-up to this election was that you're going to wipe out all the moderates from the Liberal Party, and what would be left is a very conservative coalition on that side of the political fence in Australia. You have done that. You've gotten rid of Dave Sharma, Katie Allen, Josh Frydenberg, all of these moderates. Do you think our politics is better for their absence?
Hamish, I haven't gotten rid of anyone. The people of Kooyong have chosen to elect an independent as opposed to re-electing a member that they've had for 12 years and who has not, in the last electoral cycle at least, reflected their values and what they want from their local member. What you're seeing is a number of electorates speaking in the same way. This is not something that we've done. This outcome is something that the Liberal Party has brought upon itself. And the electorate has spoken about its dissatisfaction with what that the Morrison government has provided or failed to provide in the last 3 years.
Well, so many of the voices of the Teals have exceeded expectations, and they've won. They've won the seat. But you took on the treasurer of the country. I mean, why? What possessed you?
Oh, I didn't have much else on at the time. Look, I live in Kooyong. I love Kooyong. You know, it's a beautiful part of the world. I feel very privileged to live here, but I felt that my government no longer reflected my values or what I needed and wanted from it. And so the fact that the incumbent was the treasurer of the country and the second most senior Liberal was a bit intimidating, but someone needed to do it. And so when the independent groups of Kooyong were looking for someone, I felt that I could do the job and that I should put my hand up. I didn't actually think I'd be elected. I never kind of really dared to believe that this would be the case. But, you know, what you're seeing reflects a grassroots movement from around Australia.
So, Monique, when the numbers started pouring in last night and it became pretty clear that you were going to take this seat, what were your words? What did you whisper? What did you say out loud?
I'm not sure if it's printable, Hamish, but it was like something along the lines of, oh, my goodness me.
Yeah, I think we can translate that, can't we, Hamish? We can just imagine what it was. Monique Ryan, thanks so much for joining us, and congratulations.
Thank you.